Rockets are looking to defeat their Western Conference rival going into this game.
All right, ready to go.
Welcome to the Tuesday night edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan. Joining me, Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and courtside Doris Burke. Take a look at the Mavericks. Going up against a capable opponent, but you see their confidence. This one they feel they should win. They'll look to come out strong and show they're the better team.
I guarantee you what, guys, the adrenaline is already flowing on both sides. A rivalry matchup like this means a little more to the players than just any other game.
And not just the players, Greg. How about the fans, too? I mean, they get into this thing as well. We've got an electric atmosphere in here, just like it always is when these two teams square off. This should be a good one, and I'm glad to be right in the middle of it.
And the Houston Rockets, starting five. Everly and Harden, they're the backcourt. Then there's Howard. Then it's Trevor Ariza. And it's Capella in the four slot.
He thought he had that one clean, but the ref saw it differently. They'll count the basket.
And the Rockets have lost out on some free agent wars the past few years. They have remained competitive, but you wonder what could have been if they landed or kept some of those big names.
It's Harden with the drive. Out to the wing. And there's the foul. It goes on Wesley Matthews. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the D.
Greg, no problem for me with that call. I mean, he was still sliding right there.
Now here's Harden, averaging around 27.5 points a game, one of the best in the league.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. But boy, that was a nice job.
And the layup falls.
Yes, sir.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And watch, Clark, how the game plays out, because this is going to open things up on the perimeter.
Now here's Harden. And he lobs it up toward the rim. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
And the lead just grows on that ridiculous offensive sequence.
You know, Clark, that dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop.
Yeah, that just added more to it.
And you know, guys, right now they're starting to flatline, just hanging on here for dear life.
That's a two from Matthews. Dallas, no good that time either. For the Houston Rockets, they come in off the wash to the Clippers in Los Angeles.
And listen, you have to take advantage of the freebies. And on that night, they did not. And that is why they just could not recover.
Exactly. I mean, they left too much cheese at the foul line. And in the end, it mattered on the scoreboard and cost them.
Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Houston.
Fellas, they're passing the ball the way you're supposed to here in this first half.
They've gotten their fair share of points off turnovers so far tonight, too.
Now, here's Ariza, who provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game.
Yes,
punches it down with pop.
Rubs it in. It looks like a little deeper with the hanging finish.
I tell you what, they're not backing off at all, are they?
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, you may not be as lucky next time down if you're the defense. You cannot allow him to get those kinds of looks.
Knocked loose.
Damn. Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight. Easy to see who's going to win that race.
Yeah, early offense is often easy offense. Excellent work that time.
Now, here is Harden. Capella dishes to Howard. Here's Beverly. Williams comes with a double team. Harden missing again. Mavericks trailed by five. Nowitzki, the pass to Williams. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Nowitzki. Williams has got 5 points so far.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
The 15-footer kicks it out to Harden. He dishes it to Howard. Houston moving it around. Ariza passes to Capella. Over in the corner, Beverly. And he gets it to go. Beverly's got his second bucket of the night.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
And how? I mean, they're taking this defense to task, taking them to school. Every one of their last 10 points have come in the paint.
Houston shooting their first free throws. First trip to the line in this one.
Shooting for Dallas. James
Harden hits them both. It always seems the Mavs are able to compete for a title, Clark, but their window might be closing with some of their stars aging, namely Dirk Nowitzki.
You're exactly right, Kevin, because Dirk is the centerpiece of that franchise, has been for over a decade. They made the Rondo trade last year trying for a big finals run, but eventually they'll start to have to build for the future.
The shot and game clock separated by four. And Beverly gets to Ariza. Sinks the three-pointer. Ariza's got five. Williams dishes to Parsons. To the inside. Here's Ariza. Finishes the break with a slam.
Whoa, quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and Clark offensively.
Well, one usually leads to the other, Kevin. That's just good, aggressive, attacking basketball at both ends.
Okay.
The Mavericks have gone one for one, making their previous attempt at the line.
Yeah, looking over their percentage on the season, I think they will be thrilled with the number in terms of their free throw percentage, 79.
And they've made progress in that department from last season going into this one, guys. I mean, the numbers have improved.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Offense, the order of the day as the first quarter comes to a close. Houston on top, up by seven. And we'll get going after this from the American Airlines Center. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. Let's quickly break down the game we've seen so far from the Rockets, guys.
It's been about the effort. Love the hustle they've shown here in the first.
Yeah, it's due to their hustle, as you said, Greg, and showing up on the scoreboard, too.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. So on the floor for Houston. Harden and Ariza filling out the perimeter. Then it's Patrick Beverly. Then there's Howard. And it's Capella in the four spot. Houston leading by five. In the corner, Harden. And Beverly kicks to Howard. Ariza goes in. Pass to Beverly. Now the feed to Harden. Just four to shoot. Shoots from the high post. It's rebounded by Dallas. Their last game, a win against Boston, looking to carry it into this one.
You know what, though? Not only did they get to the free throw line a lot, but they converted at a high clip.
Old school basketball here. Hard nose, fundamental, just solid old school performance right there.
And it's Ariza in the corner. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Now here's Barea. Defense is right there. And the rejection by Harden. Inside. And it's slammed in by Ariza.
Yes.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And oh. Hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Just piling on the lead with a dunk like that.
Now here's Barea. Defended by Beverly. There's the steal. And that's a foul called on J.J. Barea. That is his first foul of the game. And Beverly kicks to Howard. Back to Beverly. Poked loose. It's stolen by Barea.
That's their first of the game, though, so sharp passing has helped them to craft this lead. Not too much respect shown to him by the defenders.
And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Harden's shot is good.
He had his choice of finishing moves there, and you just gotta love the fact he went old school with the finger roll. Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand, Jim, you're right.
And I tell you what, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will start shrinking even further.
That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him.
James Harden.
Harden's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Just reliable, guys. He's just always trying to make the right play.
And there's the call on Patrick Beverley. That is his first foul of the game.
Well, we all know how loud NBA arenas can get. I mean, last season there were some accusations thrown around that it wasn't all organic. I mean, some players felt as if some of the NBA crowd noise was artificial.
And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Mavericks. The three from Harden. Again, the miss by Harden. Mavericks trailed by 7. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession. Some heavy accusations about artificial noise being pumped in last year. We've seen the issue in the NFL, talked about now in the NBA. Seeing it in other sports, there's a case that maybe the NBA's got to deal with this.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. I know some stadiums, it might feel like there is extra noise being pumped in. And listen, there are a lot of fan bases that we have are just flat out loud. I mean, it can be electric. But having said that, I don't think we want to have the artificial noise being pumped in. I think it does the game a disservice.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
Houston, a whole new 5 on the floor. .102 left now here in the second. For 3, Lawson. Passes it to Brewer. Lawson against Parsons.
Out of bounds.
Dallas takes possession.
Dallas ball.
Over the last month, let's see how the Mavericks fared in the NBA rankings. 8th in 3-point field goal percentage. 8th in fewest turnovers per game. And they're a top 10 shooting team from the foul line. Pretty good company for that team.
And they've also enjoyed a lot of success from beyond the arc. I mean, as you can see by that top 10 ranking and 3-point percentage, that's a shot they should continue to feature in their offense.
And the second free throw, good. There's 42 seconds left in the first half.
Not sure if they're aware of the 2-for-1 opportunity.
Well, they ought to be. I mean, that's basic basketball time management. You've got to be aware of your clock and your situation.
Williams kicks to Pachulia. Rebound by Harrell.
And that's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
Always important to have that good interior defense.
And Lawson with the drive. The pass to Parsons. It's taken away by Brewer. A floater. Darren Williams grabs the miss. From deep 3-point range. That one's in there. Pocket lead is cut down now to just 7 on the basket from Matthews.
Always a threat, guys. 3-point land that time was seriously expanded.
And the first half is now in the books. Rockets lead by 7. And we'll be back right after.
Okay, Dallas, stepping
up. Right, the second half beginning in just a moment. Without question, Trevor Ariza displaying his skills today.
Yeah, created a lot of quality shots for himself in that first half, and he knew when to pass it up when the double team came.
And that led to a very high points per shot number for him. For those of you that are into analytics, that stat really tells how efficient a player has been, and he's been very efficient so far.
And the third quarter about ready to get underway. Without question, Trevor Ariza displaying his skills today.
It's as if he can get to the rim any time he wants. And in that first half, he wanted to quite a bit.
And that's where his points were coming from. I mean, the defense has to do a much better job of challenging him at the rim.
Parsons and Dirk are in at the forward spots. Williams is out there with Matthews. And it's Pachulia in at the five, roaming the paint. That's the lineup in the game for Dallas. JaVale McGee's checked in for Dallas. Harden inside the three-point line. No good off the front iron.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one. And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Greg, those are always tough to judge, but I think the official got that one right.
Williams again. It's Beverly. Here's Parsons. Good. The nice assist for Williams. Parsons got his second basket of the night. It's Harden with the drive. Parsons with some nice D. Mavericks trail by eight. Williams kicks to Nowitzki. Back to Williams. Shot clock at six. On its way from Parsons for two. And it's Dallas with another.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
Harden with it. He's got 10. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. Let's use this break in the action to show you the teams that in the last 10 games have been the NBA's best fast break teams. In third, the Rockets.
I mean, no doubt for me that they've hit their stride the last few weeks. I mean, they are punishing the defenses with that up-tempo style.
Dallas making a switch here. Felton's checked in. Harden hits them both. Mavericks trail by eight. Here's Nowitzki. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
Tell you what, Kevin, they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
Clark, that deficit will go away quickly if he does.
And how about how he capped that one out, almost like the 1-2 punch.
Another miss by Houston.
That's one for their first four to start the second half.
From the arc. Good. A nice assist from Felton. And it's 7 points for Nowitzki.
Everything working for him out of the half as they've hit four of their first five shots.
And he is the ultimate when it comes to being a floor leader on the offensive end.
Yeah, you know, he's got a little bit of Greg Anthony in him. And he has been that leader today. And I think he's done a really nice job of moving the ball and distributing it the way it needs to be done.
Yeah, well, Clark, I'm glad you referenced specifically why you thought he had a little Greg Anthony. I thought you were talking about my knees, my man. he looked a little hobbled out there for a moment.
Good. Capella's got 7 points in the game.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Yeah, and that's important because this game may ultimately come down to which team controls the paint in crunch time.
Here's Harden, and he finishes nicely on the layup. And it's a 7-point Houston lead.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
Yeah, the defense is all about disrupting timing and spacing, and what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
Matthews passes to McGee.
And really a good job spotting his teammate near the bucket and then just pinpoint passing for the finish.
Felton against Beverly. Kicks to Capella. And there's the call on Felton. The Rockets have been on target from the free throw line. They're 5 of 5 in that department.
This season, in general, has not been kind to them at the free throw line. Only about 71%.
And, Kevin, it's something they've been working very hard to correct and to change. I mean, they know how important it is to fix that inability at the free throw line.
Houston making a switch here. Terrence Jones has checked in for Howard. Brewer comes in for Trevor Reese. Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for James Harden. And Ty Lawson subbed in for Patrick Beverly.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kev?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down.
Here's Brewer. Rebound by Raymond Felton.
Not too much congestion in the lane. I think he could have gotten a better shot that time, no question.
Pass to Parsons. Back to Felton. Parsons dishes to McGee. Shot clock at 5. Here's Nowitzki. Misses off the left iron. Rockets leading by 4. And some nice passing there by Houston. And Brewer kicks to Jones. And he jams it with authority.
Assisted. Maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that.
And we know he's capable of those memorable dunks.
Yeah, and when he's got a lead like that, why not take a few chances? A lot more engaging and entertaining than just doing the old ho-hum one-hander.
Boy, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. Excellent.
4 straight passes leading to scores. Great team play.
And it's sent back by Nowitzki. And that does. All right, the fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. And so here is Dallas. They trail by 6. And after this one, they're home against Minnesota. And that's the 3rd of 4 straight played at home. So on the floor for Houston. Terry and Harden are the 1 and 2. Then there's Brewer. Then there's Howard. And it's Capella in at the 4. Terry outside. Howard in the post. No good with the layup.
Well, he won't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions yet.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
10 straight points off assists. That's very impressive, and it also makes the game easy and fun to watch.
It's Harden with the drive, and he gets it to go. And the Rockets lead by 6.
Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
You know, Greg, aggressiveness is really the only option when you're on the wrong side of the size equation.
Out of bounds, Dallas will take possession.
Yeah, and I think he was surprised to see that pass coming his way and just really reacted too late.
Barea kicks to Villanueva. And here comes Lawson leading the fast break. And it's Brewer finishing it off.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg. Confident and composed on the 3-point shot at a critical juncture. Clutch.
They set the screen. Lawson the pass to Harrell. He took good advantage of that screen.
How about the screen that frees him up, though, for the jumper?
Now, here's Barea. He's tightly guarded. Felton attacking. Now the dish to Anderson. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
That's his first personal foul.
And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for Houston.
And they haven't been pushed around in the paint at all in this game. They have been the aggressors.
Something that also stands out tonight is the number of assists they have. I mean, that's a mark of a good club.
Catching up on the changes for Dallas. JaVale McGee's checked in for Pachulia. Nowitzki comes in for Charlie Villanueva. Matthews, he's checked in for Raymond Felton. And it's Williams in for J.J. Barea. And Lawson, here we go. And the layup is good.
How about that going up strong? I mean, he doesn't care how much height he's giving up. It's attitude with him.
Here's Williams. And Jones sends it back. They get it back. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
No, I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
Parsons checked in for Anderson. Houston with a big group substitution here. Howard's checked in for Harrell. Pisa comes in for Brewer. James Harden, he's checked in for Marcus Thornton. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Ty Lawson. It's Harden with the drive. And the basket good.
Yeah, that's a difficult shot in the face of a defender that towers over him.
You know, guys sometimes love proving people wrong. You know that from guys you've played with. And Greg, this mismatch gives him an opportunity to quiet the haters and naysayers.
Yeah, okay.
Here's Parsons. Hangs in midair and converts on the double clutch layup.
Oh, nice double pump finish there, strictly for the fans.
Harden outside. Power down with both hands.
And the dunk was nice, Kevin, but the move he made to free himself up was a thing of beauty.
It sure was, Greg. What a savvy play to get into position for that jam.
Heads up basketball, plain and simple, guys.
Mavericks trailed by nine to the paint. Here's Williams. The Rockets pull it in. Howard's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Jones dishes to Harden. He feeds it to Howard. Shot clock at six. Throws up the baseline. And that one's good. Beverly. And the Rockets lead by 11.
And now as the clock ticks down, this is going to end up as a solid victory here for the Rockets.
Fewer miscues made the difference, Clark.
Yeah, I thought the fact they minimized their turnovers was huge. It was a terrific all-around effort.
And you can mark this one down in the W column. It'll mark their 23rd of the season.
I mean, when you look at the stats, you'll see just how dominant a game this was for James Harden. A big part of their success was his ability to keep the ball moving, finding guys when they would flash open.
Here's Jones, and he hits it just before the shot clock expires.
This is a serious game-clenching run they're on.
Yeah, I agree with you. Just not backing off here. I mean, they're looking to close this one out in style. What a time to have this kind of surge.
Well, this one is winding down now. Houston can watch the clock run out. Now Harden. So we see Houston taking the W here. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Kevin, how about the mental toughness that this group showed? They were never rattled at all by the opposing fans.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Keller.